my name is Cynthia Dunbar, and most of you know who I am, and the reason I'm running is because many of you asked me to please step in and fight for you in Washington. Now, this is not about politics for me. This is about preserving our constitutional republic. We are being destroyed from within. And while we're being destroyed, our politicians are playing patty cake on Capitol Hill. We have liberal progressives basically putting a revolver to our head, firing round after round after round to try to destroy our nation. And those rounds that they're firing are things like fake news, education, socialism, career politicians, judicial activism, and apathy. And we have to have someone who's going to go up there and fight back. We look at fake news, and I applaud President Trump for calling out the fake news, which has happened for decades and decades with zero journalistic integrity. And they attack and attack and attack. They attack our founding fathers, they attack our Constitution, they attack our Declaration of Independence, and they attack any elected official who will actually stand up and fight for the American people. They have to. And the only ones they don't attack are truly the elected officials who are not the solution, but part of the problem. And we've seen them attack with the fake news, but we've also seen those same exact attacks in education. We have seen them come against American exceptionalism, where our students have to apologize for being Americans. We've seen the free enterprise and capitalism attacked at the total cost of promoting socialism. And then we're surprised that the third bullet, which comes out, which is socialism, is something we're shocked about. We're shocked that millennials support someone like Bernie Sanders, who's a socialist. But let's just call a spade a spade. Bernie Sanders isn't the only socialist. Hillary Clinton is. And while we're at it, let's just call out at least half, if not three-fourths, of the elected Republican elite. They're up there believing in this mythical pot of gold, handing out entitlements as cookies for votes. Things that are unconstitutional that should not be there. Things like agencies like the Department of Education, which I have fought for years and years and years and said it needs to be abolished. How can we have meaningful tax reform when we have no elected officials willing to gore any odds and say enough is enough, we're going to shrink government within the purview of the enumerated powers the founding fathers intended? And these socialists are these career politicians. They're the career politicians who are up there, and they are using these benefits, these entitlements, these unconstitutional perks to try to keep themselves in office. Now, these are not necessarily bad men and women, and they may actually even believe a lot of what they say they believe in. But at the end of the day, what they believe more than anything is staying in office, getting a higher position with a higher committee assignment, and that is a conflict of interest to us, the American people. And then they won't step in and fight. And so when we don't have these true fighters, what happens is we are now subjected to the tyranny of things like judicial activism, which actually Congress has the check of impeachment over Article 3 activism usurping Article 1 power. But when are you going to see that? You're not going to see that happen with career politicians. You're only going to see it happen with true fighters who are going to stand in the fray and fight for you. True fighters like Ted Cruz and Ron Paul, who have been trying to fight for the true liberties that we believe in as Americans. And those two leaders happen to know a conservative fighter when they see one, which is why I have the endorsement of both Ron Paul and Ted Cruz, because they know I've stood in these very trenches and I have the war wounds to prove that I am not a politician, I am a fighter. And I'm in this fight to preserve our constitutional republic. But the last bullet in the revolver that the liberals are pointing us is the silver bullet. And they're banking on this bullet, which is apathy. Because you see, we are the ultimate power in our republic. Benjamin Franklin said that they had given us a republic if we could keep it. That's the ultimate question. Can we keep it? We cannot keep it by sending politicians to Washington to do the same old tired political rhetoric and give no results. We have to stand up and say enough is enough. And we have to send true statesmen, people who will fight for you. And I have committed that if you send me there, I will only serve 3 terms, 6 years, and come back and hand it off to you, the people of the 6th District. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you.